The youngest ever shoulders to bear the heavy burden of presidential office in France. Walking the rain-sodden red carpet of welcome, Emmanuel Macron was greeted at the steps of the Élysée Palace by his political mentor, the outgoing president, François Hollande. Then they met behind closed doors, words of advice and the codes for France's nuclear deterrent were exchanged. It was a long goodbye, though. The former president emerged nearly 45 minutes later than scheduled for his final exit from the spotlight of French politics.
Nous vous reconnaissons comme grand maître de l'ordre national de la Légion d'honneur.
After receiving the highest decoration the Republic can bestow, the golden grand collar of the Legion of Honor, the new president of France gave his first speech as head of state.
Le monde et l'Europe.
The world and Europe need France now more than ever. And they need a strong France with a sense of its own destiny. A France holding high the voice of freedom and solidarity. We need a France able to invent the future.
The new occupant of the Élysée Palace now faces challenges on multiple fronts. The campaign exposed the deep divisions within France.
He can bring new things, another way of seeing things.
He believes in the tenacity of people. I trust him 100%. Everything in his program is for the renewal of France.
Breaking with tradition, the president stood in a military vehicle as he left the Élysée Palace to drive to the Arc de Triomphe to pay tribute to the sacrifices made by so many for the modern state of France. The first battle Macron faces is to build a working majority in next month's parliamentary elections.
Well, at least in the choice of candidate, he's had a very fresh approach and one could say a radical approach, because he made some good of his promise to break the political mold. He's chosen, but 80% of his candidates are coming from the civil society, people who've never been involved in politics before.
Macron said he believed France was at the dawn of an extraordinary renaissance, and the world needs what French men and women have always taught it: the audacity of freedom, the demand for equality, and the desire for fraternity. David Chater, Al Jazeera, Paris.